If your business is not on the internet, then your business will be on Office. So, Bill Gates mentioned this when he was interviewed by, don't remember, I think, Oprah Winfrey. So, my name is Alien Rakosov, a blog monetization strategies and the author of Why Best Network Published by Gramedia. Okay. In this 30 minutes to 45 minutes, I'll share the three steps how you can multiply your income through internet.
How about?
Yeah. Okay. Give yourself a round of applause before we start. Okay. Now, so that we all can get the maximum results, please silence or vibrate your phone. And if you need to answer the phone, maybe you can please go outside of the room first. And then, if you have any questions, you can ask right away and then I'll answer. Okay, can I start?
Can I start right away? Okay, thank you. Now, I want to show the proof that Bill Gates said, if your business is not on the internet, then your business will be out of business. This is the second largest bookstore in America, in United States, Borders. Borders bankrupt because Borders was too late to go to the internet. Borders didn't have website, Borders didn't use ebook, and didn't do anything about internet at all. So Borders went bankrupt. And then, in Indonesia, maybe, who knows about Aquarius? Aquarius. During high school, I usually went to Aquarius to find CDs, music, and many stuff like that. But now, during our younger generation, they no longer went to CD store. Because everything online available using iPhone, iTunes, and everything. So Aquarius also opened itself on the last day during December 31st, 2013. Aquarius cannot copy because he cannot utilize the internet to sell CDs, music, and everything else. So that's the idea. We must utilize internet to expand our business. So, times have changed. When I was young, during my grandpa's time, the television was fat. Now, the television is thin. The people who watch the television, now is fat. Right? And then, when I was still young, my mom still pick me up and go to Klontong, Klontong store. I don't know what it's called in English. Toko Klontong? Grocery. No, this is grocery. This is warung?
Warung.
Warung, yeah. Warung. Warung sudah mulai berkurang. Now, we go to minimarket or supermarket. And then, phone. Maybe if you are old enough, you experience using phone by using your point fingers to rotate. Oh, there was no speed dial. You must remember everything. If I want to call my grandpa, okay, his number is 0341. But now everything, you just use speed dial. You don't need to memorize everything. And now if we want to talk, we still use our fingers, but no longer your pointer finger, but thumbs. How we use thumbs? Talk. So you get your cell phone, like this, then using thumbs. We still use fingers, but we use thumbs.
No longer use our pointer finger.
And then,
My mom also suka ajak saya ke pasar dulu when I was still young. Why? She get me to pasar to traditional market because she wants me to help her bring the belanjaan apa?
The bags.
The bags. The bags. But now she never take me to the grocery store because she can push the cart by herself. So times have changed. In the year 2000, the internet user in Indonesia is only about 5,000 users. The Facebook user, there was none in the year 2000. In the 2013, the internet user in Indonesia is 60 million users. The Facebook users now is 55 billion users. So it increased 2,700% in just 13 years. Is it a lot or little? Lot. So everyone now goes to internet. And in the year 2000, online store almost not available. Social media is not popular. But now, every day we use WhatsApp. Even Mr. Henry, when he called, when he invites us to come to today's meeting, he used social media. Right? Right, Pat? That's right. We use social media to invite people, to meet people. We talk on the social media now. And in the year 2013, online store is everywhere. So we know about Rakuten, Lazada, Zalora, and many things else. And so, who doesn't use Facebook, Twitter, and Google will lose so many opportunities. So, I will share 3 steps how to increase your income through internet. Who wants to know?
Me.
Who wants to know? Okay. And I have good news for you. We don't need to do extraordinary things to get extraordinary results. That's by Warren Buffett. So the 3 steps that I will share to you is very, very simple. Everyone can do it. So, ready? Are you ready?
Yes.
Ready? Good. Okay, step number one. Step number one. You must be in front of your prospects. You must be in front of your audience. And it's not just you. It can be your business, your products, your services. So I have questions now. If people go to internet, where they go to find something on the internet?
Google.
Google. Why Google? The biggest search engine. Yes, that's very good. So your prospects must be able to find you on the internet. That's why you must be on Google. You must be on the first page of Google. Yeah. Let's see here. This is a chart that I took from an authority website that measure the number of visitors to a certain website. Now we can see here, top sites in Indonesia, google.com is number one. Google.com. Everyone in Indonesia goes to Google if they go to internet. And not just Google, see here, number 6, google.co.id. So, we must be friends with Google if we want to get money from the internet. Is this clear so far? Okay. So, Google is very, very, very powerful. Even one of my friends, every time she wants to go to Facebook, she never types facebook.com. She went to Google and then type Facebook. Is that you, Ali? she was before, but now she remembers facebook.com. Yeah, Google is very, very powerful. Everyone uses Google. So, step one, you must be in front of your prospects so that your prospects must be able to find you or your business or your services or your product. You must be on Google first page. Why you must be on Google first page?
Kenapa harus di halaman yang pertama? Kok di halaman berikut-berikutnya?
5.
Oke, okay, let's go. Oke, okay, let me give you. Oke, okay, sir. Oke, okay, give me a round of applause. Yeah, because if we go to Google, usually we only browse on the first page. We seldom go to the second page, if the third page, and the so on. So, you must be on the Google first page. Now, who wants to know how to be on Google first page? Who wants to know? SEO, okay. We'll talk about simple SEO. Search engine optimization. Okay. So, this is one of my friends' website. So, I have friends whose website can be on Google first page and on the first rank on Google. First rank on the Google. Okay. Let's see here. We go live here. Cara menjual tanpa menjual. How to sell without selling. My friend's website is the first page. It's on the first page, on the first rank, on the topmost. And he beats, you can see, how many competition? 20 million competition. So the step that I will share you is very simple. If you follow it, you can be on Google first page. So imagine, if you are on Google first page, will you get so many visitors? Will you get money? Will you get money?
Not yet.
Not yet. Yes, good question. Good answer, sir. Yes. Even though you will be on Google first page, there's no guarantee that you will get money. That will be the second step and the third step that I will share it. Share to you. Is this clear so far, or do you have any questions? Clear? Okay. So this is my first friend's website. The first friend on the Google first page. Within 17.6 million competitor, but we just saw that now the competition increased to 20 million. And this is last night. I captured it last night. Imagine, in just less than 24 hours, your competition grew by 3 million. But he's still on the first. So, what happens if you have no website? Will you be on the Google first page? Will you be on Google?
No.
Who thinks you cannot be on Google if you have no website? Siapa yang berpikir tidak bisa muncul di Google kalau tidak punya website?
Nah.
Pasti bisa. Pasti bisa. How? Bagaimana caranya?
Facebook.
Kenapa? I don't know. But you know it's possible, right? Yes. It's very possible. It doesn't have to be your website.
Thank you.
It can be anything on the internet. It can be your video. Or even your slide presentation. Whoever makes video here? Ada yang pernah make video? Can people find your video on the internet?
Yes.
Yes. Oh yeah, you upload the video to YouTube. Or how about slide presentation? To have your slide presentation to be on Google is also very simple. So I give an example here. Business 2014. This one. This is my slide presentation on Google first page on the first time. Slide, not website. Slide. Slide presentation. And this is video. Video uploaded by one of my friends here, Nurul. She's still in high school, but she can create video and she can upload video to the web. Another video by my friend. Video. Who wants to know how you can upload your slides to the internet? Who wants to know? Siapa yang mau tahu caranya? So you can create your video, your slide using PowerPoint. Using PowerPoint. Okay. To get slide on the internet. First step, you create your presentation, right? Using PowerPoint. PowerPoint. And then you make your presentation into a PDF file. Usually PowerPoint is PPT, right? PPT. But now you create it into make it into a PDF file. How to make it into a PDF file? You can just simply print and then choose save as PDF. After that, you upload your PDF presentation to many slides presentation online. For example, slideshare.net. It's very simple to do. So if you have presentation or you have Word document, you can convert them into PDF, you can upload to slideshare.net, and then people can find it. So, how about video? Who wants to be able to create video? Siapa yang mau bisa bikin video? No one? Pakai handycam. Okay, there is a simple method to create video. Smartphone cam. But you can also make your photo, your pictures, anything into a video. You can also get traffic, you can also get audience using your pictures. And the process is also very simple. You can open a website. Okay. You can use website. The website is called Animoto.com. So you can create video using this website. And it's very simple to create it. One slide on the internet, we use SlideShare. So video, create video. Video you can choose using create by using Animoto.com. Or you can use Sparkle.com. They're all free. You can use to create video without paying anything. And then after you create your video, you upload your video to video sites such as YouTube.com, Vimeo.com, and so many on. Many of my friends already get traffic from using video. It's very, very simple. Unfortunately, the internet connection is slow, so I cannot show you how to get video directly. Slide presentation, video on YouTube, video on Vimeo. Or if you don't have video or you don't have any slide presentation, people can still find you on the internet. How? No? LinkedIn, yes, good. LinkedIn can. Or Twitter.
Facebook, Twitter, Facebook, or anything on the internet. It's very easy to be on the internet, but be careful. Everything that goes into the internet, you cannot delete it. So, be very careful. Internet can be your friend, can also be your enemies. Jadi hati-hati. Ya, jadi kalau pakai ini lagi foto-foto misalnya lupa, baru mandi pas foto, belum pakai pakaian terus ke upload gitu. Wah, itu susah kalau sudah menyebar. Kita tidak bisa tariknya lagi. Yeah. Okay. So treat your smartphone with very very private. Don't let anyone to get your smartphone. Okay. Let me give an example here. My friend from Bandung, he has websites. But what appears on Google is his Facebook profile, Instagram, slash share, Instagram, Twitter. His Facebook is still way below. But people can still find him on the internet. So after you go home from here, make your Facebook, create your Twitter, create your Instagram, anything. You create it, it's free. Then the next question. You already know how to be on Google, right? You can use anything to be on Google. The next question. How can you be on Google first page? This is the next question. We already answered the first question. How you can be on Google? You can use any means to be on Google. But now the next question, how can you be on Google first page? Keyword. Yes, very good. Keyword. Using keyword. Hey. Oh. Kasih kesempatan. Kok gini aja ini semua ya? Media lainnya belum.
Belum.
Marketer semua nih di sini.
Belum, bukannya juga.
IT. Yeah. Yeah, she's right. You use keyword with little competition. You choose keyword with little competition. You can find the keyword using what we call Google Keyword Planner. Google Keyword Planner is free. You can use it for free. Just go to this address, adwords.google.com. You register AdWords account, and then you can go using Google Keyword Planner for free, without paying anything. Who wants to use Google Keyword Planner? Siapa mau coba pakai? Oh, coba pakai. Agar kita semua bisa mengerti, so that we all can understand how powerful keyword, I will show you a study case. Please answer this in Indonesian. What picture is this? Gambar apa ini? Sepatu apa? Sepatu perempuan? Yakin sepatu perempuan? Are you sure it's women's shoes? Sepatu untuk apa?
Untuk
nendang, Pak. Aduh, kasih. Sepatu kerja? Sepatu kerja wanita? Sepatu formal? Sepatu pesta? Oke, apa lagi? Sepatu hal tinggi? Oke, what else?
Mantap.
High heel shoes? Oke, sepatu kulit? Leather shoes? Sir, you want to comment? Huh? Yes. Ladies shoes. Okay, good. Ada lagi? Murah. Sepatu murah. Okay, apa lagi? What else? Cheap shoes. Apa lagi? Oh, guess. You can guess anything. Gratis. Oh, saya juga mau sepatu gratis. Sepatu gratis. Okay. let's see what Google said about this picture. Okay? Because everything, jadi semuanya yang sudah kita tebak itu percuma, karena yang menentukan adalah Google. Betul? Menentukan adalah Google, kan? Kita lihat, menurut Google ini adalah suatu kerja wanita. Suatu kerja wanita. Working lady shoes. It is according to Google. Suatu kerja wanita. Working lady shoes. Okay? Now, what picture is this? Gambar apa ini? Sama? Ya, kalau sama Google-nya juga bingung dong. Gambar apa? What picture is this? Suatu kerja wanita, oke. Okay. What else? Suatu kerja wanita hitam, oke. Okay. Good. Next. Oh ya, silakan tadi. Suatu kerja wanita hitam. Nah, ini tadi berbeda. Oke. Okay. Give her applause, everyone. Suatu kerja wanita hitam. Black work lady shoes. Black work lady shoes. Oke. Okay. What else? Apa lagi? Sama. Tebak, ada yang salah di sini. Semuanya benar. Ada lagi? Sepatu gratis. Oke, okay, sepatu gratis. Sepatu buta. Oke. Okay. Now, sekarang kita lihat ya, apa kata Google ya. Udah siap? Siap? Siap untuk tahu apa jawaban Google? Siap ya? Sepatu pantofel wanita. Nah, women's lover. Women lovers. Women lovers. Sepatu pantofel. Menurut Google ini adalah sepatu pantofel. Menurut kita tadi apa? Sepatu kerja wanita, sepatu hitam, sepatu hak tinggi, dan lain-lain. Tapi Google berkata lain. Nah kita mau gimana? Kita mesti ngikutin Google kan? Yang mengeluarkan foto-foto ini mengeluarkan pencarian kan Google, bukan kita. Benar? Nih, now, one more time. What picture is this? Gambar apa ini? Fancy swimming shoes. Oke, okay, that's good, Pak. Oh, belum ada. Terus lagi, Pak. Oke. Okay. Kasih tangan dong. Oke. Okay. Sepatu kerja apa tadi? Sepatu fancy wanita. Oke. Okay. What else? Apa lagi? Apa tadi ada yang bilang sepatu feminin ya?
Sepatu kasual. Lihat lagi, Pak.
Masa casual pakai sepatu gini sih, hak tinggi. Nah, yang para wanita, coba tolong jawab, kalau casual pakai sepatu seperti ini nggak? Sepatu pesta wanita, oke Pak. Beda lagi jawabannya, oke silakan Pak. Oke, kasih tepuk tangan. Oke ya, kita lihat ya jawaban Google apa. Siap? Siap? Lihat jawaban Google? Siap ya? Sepatu kantor wanita. So, from these pictures, from these three previous slides, itu apakah sepatu yang sama sebenarnya? Sama? Were they all the same shoes? Gak samanya di mana, Pak?
Haknya heel.
Haknya heel ya. Oke, okay. Ini ada yang tinggi di sini. Ini juga Pak hak. Hak juga. Ini juga hak. Semuanya ada hak. Sepatunya tinggi. Tapi kenapa Google berkata lain?
Karena Google
oke, okay, nah sekarang saya mau tanya ke para wanita ya. Seandainya ada toko sepatu nih, terus cari misalnya sepatu kerja wanita, Anda disodorinya bukan sepatu yang seperti di sini, tapi dikasihnya sepatu yang di sini. Apakah Anda akan pakai untuk kerja ke kantor? Pakai ya? Oke. Okay. Kalau misalnya dikasihnya sepatu seperti ini, pakai juga ke kantor. Loh, berarti kan barangnya sama, fungsinya sama untuk dipakai ke kantor. Benar?
What's the difference? Apa bedanya? Oh, this is very important for the next test. Guess, guess, you can guess. Bisa tebak, apa bedanya?
Usia
mawar. Oke, kalau gitu saya kembali. Ini adalah kaitannya dengan keyword. Dengan search engine optimization. Apa pengaruhnya tiga tadi? Sepatu kantor wanita. Yeah. So what's the difference between sepatu kerja wanita, women work shoes, sepatu pantal wanita, women slippers, dan sepatu kantor wanita? Barangnya akan sama. Benar, barangnya akan sama. Iya. So what's the difference?
Sama.
Mindsetnya. Jadi orang yang cari sepatu kerja wanita, kalau ketemunya sepatu pantofel nggak mau pakai. Pakai juga kan? Gitu. Jadi apa? Keyword benar. Keywordnya kenapa? Tiap gambar punya keyword berbeda. Oke. Lalu signifikansinya untuk kita apa? Sebagai pemilik toko sepatu misalnya. Oke, kita harus tahu keyword apa yang biasanya di digunakan orang. Oke. Kasih tepuk tangan aja yuk. Oke, very good answers. We have to know what keywords people use to find your product. Kenapa, Pak? Nah, tadi jawabannya itu bagus, tapi itu baru the first answer. Masih ada jawaban kedua. What is the next answer? Kita harus tahu keyword apa yang digunakan oleh orang untuk cari produk kita. Itu sudah benar. But there is another step, another answer that we have to know. Apakah itu? Ada yang ingin tahu? Siapa yang mau tahu? Angkat tangan nih yang mau tahu. Oke, ya. Jadi, kita lihat langsung. We'll see the difference using Google Keyword Planner. Jadi, open adwords.google.com. I cannot go live because the internet connection is slow, so I will give you screenshot. Okay? So, this is screenshot of Google Keyword Planner. There are more than three columns, but in this exercise, I will provide only three columns here to make it simpler for you to understand. So, the first column is keyword. Keyword means the keyword that people use to search on the internet. Ya, jadi kalau pertama adalah keyword, jadilah kata-kata yang digunakan oleh orang untuk mencari di internet. Ya, sejauh ini jelas? Ya. Berikutnya, average monthly searches. Rata-rata pencarian dalam waktu 1 bulan. Berikutnya, competition. Competition itu adalah tingkat kompetisinya. Tinggi, sedang, atau rendah. Sejauh ini cukup jelas? Oke, ya. Oke. Keyword tadi, personalization dan competition. Now, let's open this gray box. Nah, see over here, sepatu kerja wanita. Berapa pencariannya per bulan rata-rata? 1,600, 1,600 pencarian per minggu. Per bulan. Ini banyak atau sedikit? Sedikit banyak itu relatif ya kita. Nah, see the competition high, tinggi, competition tinggi. Jadi kita tidak hanya memperhitungkan jumlah pencarian, tapi kita juga harus perhitungkan jumlah kompetisi kita, the competitors. The harder competition, the harder for us to be on Google first page. But it's useless to be on Google first page if nobody is looking for that keyword. Ya? Jadi, kalau kompetisi tinggi, susah bagi kita untuk bisa muncul di laman pertama Google. Ya? Kita bisa menggunakan keyword lain yang kompetisi sedikit agar kita bisa muncul di laman pertama Google. Tapi, kalau keyword itu tidak ada yang cari, Percuma kita muncul dalam ramah Google. Betul? Ya. Yeah. So we have to find the balance. We have to find the balance. So we have to find the balance. Okay. Baik. Ini
Combination.
This is number of search, jumlah pencarian. Kita harus temukan balance-nya. Ya. Kita harus temukan balance. Jadi kalau misalnya gini, ini banyak yang cari, tapi kompetisinya juga tinggi. Betul? If the graphic is like this, there are many people who's looking for the product using that keyword, but the competition is also very tight. What if it's like this? Less competition, but less searches. So we have to find the balance. And the balance, you yourself that can decide. Tidak ada yang bisa menentukan di mana simbangannya. Hanya Anda sendiri yang bisa menentukan. Saya mau pilih keyword yang banyak dicari, kompetisi tinggi, atau keyword yang sedikit dicari tapi kompetisi rendah. Nah itu di mana Anda menemukan titik equilibrium ini terserah Anda masing-masing. Maybe if you like challenge, you choose high competition. If you don't really like high challenge, you choose lower competition. And that's okay. That's all depends on you. Okay. Sejauh ini jelas? Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. Ini sepatu kerja wanita. Sekarang kita lihat berikutnya. Sepatu pantofel wanita. Sepatu pantofel wanita. Berapa pencarian per bulan? 840 pencarian. Sedikit atau banyak? Sudah. Lebih sedikit kalau dibandingkan yang tadi 1600. But the competition is medium. How about sepatu kantor wanita? 390 pencarian, kompetisi tinggi. Enak gak kalau seperti ini? Coba kita bandingkan, ini 1600 yang cari. Ini 880 yang cari, ini 390. Barangnya sama. Benar kan? Barangnya sama, tadi kita lihat gambarnya. Kalau misalnya Anda punya produk sepatu kantor wanita, Anda pilih gunakan keyword yang mana? Kenapa?
Sepatu?
Pantofel. Sepatu? Kerja wanita? Kenapa? Why?
Mana?
Ya, so dari tiga keyword ini, mana yang mau dipilih? Suppose you have a store that sells women working shoes. Anda pilih kata kunci yang mana? Pilih keyword yang mana? Yang paling bawah. Yang paling bawah yang cari kan paling sedikit, kompetisi paling tinggi. Masa dipilih? Paling atas. Yakin paling atas. Banyak yang cari kompetisi tinggi kalau tidak muncul halaman pertama gimana? Kayak carut. Oke. Ya, good answer. Kalau saya pribadi, apalagi untuk pemula, saya akan pilih sepatu pantofel wanita. Kenapa? So, even though pencarian yang hanya separohnya tadi sepatu kerja wanita, kompetisinya jauh lebih sedikit. Akan lebih mudah muncul di halaman pertama. Halaman pertama dan halaman kedua itu jumlah trafiknya beda, bisa beda 1/10 loh. 1/10. So, kalau pencariannya 1600, tapi tidak muncul di halaman pertama Google, munculnya di halaman kedua. Cuma dapat 1/10 dari 1600, 160. 160 dan 880, lebih banyak mana? Lebih banyak 880. Makanya kalau saya pribadi, saya pilih yang kompetisi lebih sedikit. Biarpun pencariannya tidak terlalu banyak. Yang penting nongol di peringkat atas di halaman pertama. Sejauh ini jelas? Berguna? Oke, saya lanjut ya. Mau saya kasih contoh lagi? Mau contoh lagi? Boleh? Oke, kasih contoh ya. Sekarang, I use keyword usaha rumah makan versus bisnis rumah makan. In English, it means the same meaning. What is it? Restaurant business opportunity. In English, it means the same thing. In Indonesia, they use different words, usaha dan bisnis. Apa bedanya kedua keyword ini? Traffic, oke, jumlah pencarian, lalu? Menurut kita artinya kira-kira sama atau berbeda? Artinya sama? Oke, betul. Artinya sama ya. Orang yang mencari ini ingin menginginkan hal yang sama. Ya, mereka inginkan hal yang sama. Namun yang berbeda adalah jumlah pencarian dan jumlah kompetisi. Usaha rumah makan 390 pencarian per bulan, kompetisi medium. Bisnis rumah makan jumlah pencarian 390, jumlah pencarian low. Which one you choose? Suppose you promote your restaurant business. Which one you choose? Pilih yang mana? Yang mana? Ini. Kenapa nggak yang ini? Kenapa? Kompetisi. Nah ini kan lebih banyak. Kenapa? Kita pilih yang bisnis. Padahal yang usaha lebih banyak nih. Orang cenderung pakai bisnis, oke. Nah itu juga bisa. Cuma di sini kita lihat jumlah pencariannya selisihnya tidak terlalu banyak, hanya selisih 70 pencarian per bulan. Tapi kompetisinya jauh lebih sedikit. So it's easier if we choose bisnis rumah makan. Nah, sekarang Anda sudah bisa muncul dalam pertama Google. Sudah bisa belum? Sudah ya, sudah bisa. Sudah bisa dapat income? Belum. Kenapa belum? Kan udah muncul halaman pertama Google. Kenapa? Tidak ada penawaran. Oke. Kalau sudah ada penawaran, bisa dapat uang. Belum tentu. Oke. So, the first step, the second step. Your prospect must be able to contact you. Jadi, walaupun Anda punya penawaran, even though you have website, people can find your website, people can find your offer. If they cannot contact you, you will not have money. So imagine, like you pasang iklan misalnya di koran Kompas, pasang iklan, ya satu halaman gede gitu ya, bayar 50 juta pasang iklan. Please, misalnya apa? Sepatu kerja wanita eksklusif, dipakai oleh para permaisuri dari berbagai negara. Nah gitu, Anda mau? Mau, orang baca mungkin mau, tapi Anda waktu bikin iklan kirim ke Kompas Anda lupa, tidak ada keterangan beli di mana, tidak ada keterangan untuk bisa pesan di mana. Nah, ini yang sering terjadi juga, kadang orang lupa. Their website or their offer doesn't have contact information, so that people can cannot contact. So you must write your contact information on your website or on your offer. And you must give incentive. You must give incentive so that your prospects contact you. I will give an example. Also, a few weeks ago, my washer at home got broken. Jadi mesin cuci di rumah rusak. Cannot wash. Okay, bisa cuci. Dia bisa cuci. Tapi tidak bisa mengeras. Nah, jadi akan bapak semua. So, and then I call the technician. The technician said to me, okay, sir, the spare part is not available anymore. I can fix it right now, but in a few days, it will akan rusak lagi dalam beberapa hari. Jadi, saya tidak mau harus cari mesin cuci baru untuk mengganti di rumah. So, I searched the internet. And then I found many websites, but washer. Tentang mesin cuci. Dan saya akhirnya masuk ke salah satu website. Lihat, ternyata mesin cuci itu banyak pilihannya. Betul ya, banyak pilihan. Nah, saya bingung mau pilih yang mana. I was confused, we want to choose. Ada di situ, di website ada tulisan order now, phone order, pesan lewat telepon. saya saja tidak tahu mau pilih mana, gimana mau pesan? Benar? Misalnya Anda menemukan suatu penawaran, lalu Anda masih bingung, apakah mungkin Anda akan pesan atau beli? Nah, kan? Tidak beli. So, contact information is useless. We must give incentive so that people contact. Contact info. Must give incentive so that prospects can contact you. I will give two examples. The first one, gratis konsultasi. Coba saya buka website itu. Bingung mesin cucinya mana? Lalu ada tulisan, gratis konsultasi. Nah, apalagi kalau tulisan, dengan pakar mesin cuci. Kira-kira telepon nggak Bapak Ibu? Telepon ya? Jadi misalnya ada cari mesin cuci, terus bingung mesin cuci mana? Yang ada tulisannya gratis konsultasi dengan mesin cuci, nomor ini. Ada telepon ya? Cucinya? Good. Halo? Berikutnya, gimana kalau ditulisin hampir habis? Nelfon nggak? Pesan? Huh? How about if it's almost sold out? Will you buy or will you call?
Yes.
Ada yang mungkin nelfon, ada yang nggak. Ya? Gimana kalau ditulisin? Hanya tinggal satu unit. If you really need that product, most certainly you will call. Because it's the last unit. So you must give incentive so that people contact you. Contact information is not enough. You must also put incentive. I still have so many example of incentive. You can get it in my website, mantrawang.net/bonus. Nah, bisa ambil di sini. Tulisan bonus harus huruf besar. Kalau tidak di huruf besar, tidak bisa dibuka. I have so many example of incentive. You can see here. You can get it for free. Okay. Now, kalau ini dilakukan, post you use it on your BlackBerry Messenger, nah, bakal banyak nih yang respon. Kasih insentif orang ping. Ping. Nah, this is Komar's screenshot. So, Komar practice what I tell him, because the result. Oh, okay. Lalu juga orang bisa langsung tanya di luar SMS. Tanya, gimana cara dapetinnya? Because we already give the incentive, but we didn't tell him how. So we force him to contact us. Okay. Sejauh ini jelas? Ya? Yeah. Okay. Step 3. Your prospects must choose you. Ya, orang sudah lihat website Anda, sudah menemukan website Anda, sudah menghubungi Anda, tapi belum tentu dia pilih untuk beli dari Anda. Betul? So, your prospects must choose you. Anda harus bikin prospek Anda memilih Anda. Gimana caranya? You must give irresistible offer. Kasih penawaran menggiurkan sekali sampai lidahnya ngeces sekali telepon Anda. Kalau ini Anda lakukan, ya orang nanti bisa langsung SMS Anda, tanya, apa nomor rekening Anda? Saya mau langsung. Ini teman saya dari Cilegon, dia mempraktikkan, lalu bisa. Dia kaget, dia tidak kenal dengan orangnya, tapi orang bisa langsung bisa. Saya mau transfer, mana? Kalau ini seandainya bisa terjadi, gimana rasanya? Senang? Hah? Siapa yang mau? Oh, mau? Oke. Okay. Nah. So, saya akan kasih contoh. I'll give the example of irresistible offer. Next one. Ya, dijamin paling murah, apakah diganti selisihnya paling rumah. Paling, bukan selisihnya 10 kali 4. Guarantee the cheapest one. Or, we reimburse you. Selisih apa sih? The difference, 10 times. Berikutnya, bayar sekali gratis setahun. Ini sudah saya praktekkan. Jadi saya mempunyai berbagai program. Suatu ketika pernah saya bikin, orang cukup bayar sekali, boleh datang gratis selama setahun. Kira-kira berapa orang yang datang lebih dari satu kali? Bisa dihitung jari. So I charge like 3 times, 5 times. They only pay once. They can come anytime in 1 year, but people only come once. Enak gitu, dapat duit langsung dibuka 5 kali lipat, orang cuma dapat sekali. Ini yang punya apa?
tempat salon mobil paling jago pakai ini. Bayar sekali, gratis poles mobil setahun. Satu dua minggu pertama mungkin rajin ya, mau mobil poles. Lama-lama males. Atau siapa yang di sini pernah pernah ikut apa membership gym, misalnya live fitness atau ini? Bayarnya biasanya gimana? Setahun. Datangnya berapa sering? Yeah. So you can use this one. People is lazy. They are lazy. They only like to buy, but they never come. They never use it. You get the money, right? Jadi harus praktekkan. Nah, contoh-contoh lainnya bisa Anda lihat di sini, manrawang.net/bonus. Nah, apakah berguna tiga langkah tersebut? Berguna? Nah, saya mau tanya sekarang. Tadi itu semua adalah income. All these three steps can help you to increase your income. Nah, the question. Apakah income sama dengan profit? Bukan. Apakah income sama dengan profit? Income? Yes or no? No. Okay. So if you increase your income, doesn't mean your profit. So one of my friend is from Bandung. Dulu dia hanya dapat profit per transaksi hanya 250.000. Setelah dia mempraktekkan, dia profit per transaksi 2,5 juta. Naik 1000%. Kira-kira seperti itu enak atau tidak? Enak. Nah, siapa yang mau kalau bisa? One. Nanti di April saya ada seminar. Seminar tingkatkan profit Anda. Seminar ini investasi 300.000. Tapi bagi teman-teman di sini, kita semua udah jadi teman nih. Kalau Anda ada yang mau datang ke seminar, nanti akan saya berikan tiketnya gratis. Bawa. Oke, nanti silakan langsung daftar ke Pak Komar. Ya, bagi Anda yang mau nanti dan kedatangan Pak Komar, kita catat nama, nomor telepon, HP, akan diberitahukan nanti tempat dan lokasinya. Bagi Anda yang mau datang nanti bisa hadir. Oke. Oke, terima kasih. Thank you for your attention. Semoga ini bisa membantu.